Hey, what's going on, guys? This is iBornstellar, and today I'll be talking about the most recent Battlefield 3 news, in addition to also linking you off to some awesome Battlefield videos that the community has been making for the past few days. And hopefully, I guess towards the end, I'll actually be talking about the actual gameplay that I did today. With that, let's get down to the news stories, because there's quite a bit to talk about today. So the first news story, Battlefield 3 core gameplay designer leaving BF3, which is a kinda sad for me, because I mean, the guy that's leaving is Alan Kurtz, which is like the main guy that does pretty much everything about the tweaking of guns, changes that will be happening, you know, soon. So, and you know, I always say Alan Kurtz said blah 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 blah. So, kind of sucks that he's leaving, but he's not leaving DICE, but he's still going to be at DICE, but he's gonna be working on some other stuff. So. Here are some quotes from his Twitter account, which says, quote, "Moving on from BF3, leaving the gameplay in the very capable hands of Gustav Hailing and Storm Monster," which I think are the other two gameplay designers. It says, "I will still need, I will still read and pass on, I guess, on, you know, feedback and stuff." And also the next quote reads, "And no, I'm not leaving DICE, just departing from the team that's still diligently working on BF3, so, you know, once again, that means that he's not leaving DICE, he's just gonna be working on some other stuff that, who knows what that stuff is going to be about, but, which is kinda related to the next news story, which, it says a DICE to begin development of next generation of titles? Question mark? So this is basically a rumor, so this is not confirmed, just stuff out on the internet that people I pretty much kind of deduced, but it's not confirmed. So, you know, don't take this as confirmation of things to come, but probably, you know, something new in the future. So, within the past month, we've noticed that the DICE is beginning to intensify their search to fill job openings among the DICE team, most noticeably for concept artists. Examples of these include cinematic artists, concept artists, level artists, a lot of artists, and technical artists, senior 2D UI artists, senior level artists, just tons of stuff. But interestingly, the description under the backend developer position also mentions words of, quote, next generation titles, end quote. And so it reads, "DICE is looking for a world-class backend developer to join our online team and help propel this system to the next level for our next generation of titles." So what that means is that, you know, well, obviously DICE is making, or at least planning to make, new games for the future. What those games will be, who knows? It could be, you know, many of you guys hopefully are waiting for Mirror's Edge 2. Maybe, I mean, I'm probably not gonna say a whole lot of you are waiting for a Metal 1 or 2, but I mean, that's confirmed at this point. Maybe some other Battlefield title, Battlefield, maybe Bad Company 3 this time around, Battlefield 2143, 1944 perhaps? I mean, I don't even know what they'll be making next, but whatever it is, I hope it's good, because so far DICE is making awesome games. I mean, pretty much every game that they made so far is pretty awesome. I mean, I haven't played Mirror's Edge, I played like the demo, and it was pretty cool, but I didn't actually, you know, buy the game, so. But maybe Mirror's Edge 2 will do it for me, so. But that's that, so, you know, I guess we only have to, the only thing that we can do is just wait and see for what DICE will do. So moving on to the next news story, which is about the Dogtags that many of you guys may or may not have at this point, if you didn't get them from, if you pre-order, or if you didn't get them from me, or, you know, if you got some Dr. Pepper codes from some other places. So, Battlefield 3 Dogtags and multiplayer skins bundles available today for PS3, next week for 360 and PC. So the Spectact and Dogtag bundle, priced at $3 or €3, packs in 10 Dogtags and a set of new multiplayer skins. It's worth noting that the content of this bundle was part of the pre-order bonus for Battlefield 3. So these include, hold on real quick, can open the picture so I can see what the actual dog tags will look like, so you know what you're paying for. So one is one of a pirate, the other one's the one of a dinosaur, another prior one. One that says Hags was here, which is one of the guys from Back Company 2, or, you know, just the Back Company series. Another one that says, like, has a bunch of lines, you know, saying, you know, I've killed these many guys. And it says at the end, counting, so pretty cool. So very awesome Dogtags. I think I got these because of the limited edition, I'm pretty sure. So I already had these, but if you don't have them, they're going to be $3 or €3. And I'm not sure about the multiplayer skins, so I'm not sure what those are, but anyway. And the other ones are the promo bundle, which are, I think are the ones from the Dr. Pepper stuff. So the promo bundle will include, or will also, like, set you back for $3 or €3, same price. And it features 10 dog tags and one skin, which I think is the one that you will get from Dr. Pepper promotion. The items in the bundle were promotional items for Battlefield 3 North America, from Dr. Pepper stuff, that's now available to everyone to purchase. And I guess real quick, I'm going to open the picture so I know which ones you're going to be buying if you actually buy the bundle for $3, which are, yeah, pretty much all the ones from the Dr. Pepper promotion, which is, of course, the Roar dog tag with the dinosaur, the one with the wolves, the Bye Kitty, the one with the bunch of bones, the Friday one, and some other ones like the rabbit dog. There's one of a snake, and one of with a skull with, like, bat wings, and one of a burning skull, and some other ones. So pretty cool. You know, if you didn't get these from me, from the Dr. Pepper stuff, the giveaways that I was, you know, doing for the past 2 months on November and December, then now I guess this is your chance to actually get them. You know, it'll cost you, well, $6 if you want to get all of them, but you know, they're pretty cool. So, like, right now I'm using the I'm still using the Roar one because it's so cool. I love that one. So I guess that's it, you know. And once again, the bundles are available today on the PlayStation Network, except for Asia, where they will be available on January 19th. Xbox 360 and PC, the bundle will be available to be, you know, for purchase in 1 week on Xbox Live for 240 points, which is $3, and on Origins. So if you have it for PS3, you can get it right now. 360 and PC users get it, you know, next week on Xbox Live and Origin respectively. So, but with that, we move on to the next news story, which is about some poster that a few guys made about Battlefield 3. And you know, I'm sure you guys will find these interesting because they're pretty cool. So the first one is about hold on real quick, I'm gonna load up the images. So the first one is it's called it doesn't have a name actually. I'll just read you what it says. It says it's not kill stealing, it's saving your life. And it has the emblem, I guess, of when you save one of your teammates. Like, I think what it's called, Rescuer or something. I forgot what the actual title is. Real quick, I went to battle log. Oh, the Savior ribbon. That's what it is. So it has the Savior ribbon, you know, thing on it. It says it's not kill stealing, it's saving your life. So there you go. You know, when somebody takes your kill, they were trying to save you. So there you go. And the next one is it says play the objective, and it has, you know, A, B, C, D, and C is in red, meaning it's under attack. So go after C and, you know, recapture it or whatever. So play the objective if you're playing Battlefield. Screw the KD. But, you know, it's always nice to get a good KD too. And the final one, it's called, or it says, where's your squad, soldier? And, of course, it means, you know, you should always squad up, and you should always, you know, keep in mind what other people are doing. So if you, I don't know, see one guy, like you have three guys in your squad, right? And one of them is a recon, one of them is a is a medic, the other one's a support class. What should you be? Probably an engineer. You know, maybe a medic. I mean, it's always a good thing to have more medics. So, you know, always check out what your squad is doing so you can help them out in some way. So if you see one of your teammates, like, you know, in the spawn screen, you see them without ammo and they're asking for it, probably switch to a support class so you can give them some ammo, you know. So always play your role, you know, as always I always say, so. Be a team player, so don't be a lone wolf. But anyway, that's the time where we move on to the awesome videos that the community has been making for the past few days, which there's quite a bit of them. So there's 13 videos that I found which are definitely worth watching. So the first one, which is from the N04 or 004 500, it's called Only in Battlefield and it's from Battlefield 1943, actually. So I'll be showing you guys, or linking you off rather, to videos from pretty much any Battlefield game. It doesn't have to be from, you know, Battlefield 3 only. So this one's from BF 1943, like I said, and it's some pretty awesome stuff happening, because I think some idiot left a jet lying around in front of a tree, and this guy just happened to actually take off from this really weird or awkward position. So, like, whoever stuck to the jet, or not really a jet, more like a plane now, in front of a tree, he managed to actually get out of there and actually take off. So it was really cool. Definitely check out the video. It's really short, it's like a minute long, so really cool. Check it out. But moving on to the next one, which is called Skid Loader Delivery by Clint Beeswood. So this is a video very similar to, I don't know if you guys have seen Freddie Wong's commercial that they did for EA, which has they put C4 on a skid loader and they drive it up to a building and blow it up, and it's pretty awesome because, you know, you don't really get to see that all that often on TV of a skid loader blowing up thanks to C4, but that's pretty much what this guy did on you know, the actual game. They put a bunch of C4 on a skid loader and drove it up to, I think it was an objective, I think, and just blew it up. Oh wait, I think it was up to a tank, actually. So it was really cool, really funny video. Definitely check it out. And I guess, you know, if you haven't seen the Freddie Wong's BF3 commercial, I'll just put it as a notation or in the description so you can guys check it out. And as always, you know, real quick, everything that I do will be as an annotation on the video itself and also in the description. So if you are wondering where I'm getting my links from, where I'm getting my information from, definitely check out the description for links to everything that I talk about. So, but with that, we move on to the third video, which is called Battlefield 3. I have no idea what I'm doing, by Fenty Kurz, and it's just, you know, a really simple video of him doing some funny stuff, you know, getting killed a lot, failing a little bit, but just, you know, a good entertaining video that you guys may find, like I said, entertaining. So, you know, nothing amazing, just some funny stuff that happens to him. So, but with that, we move on to the fourth video, which is called Battlefield 3, Russians Don't Dance. And I think these two next clips are by Ingle Summer, so this guy has been making a lot of videos lately, which are pretty funny. So this one is called Battlefield 3, Russians Don't Dance by Ingle Summer 4. And it's just a funny clip of some guys shuffling. Yeah, that should give you a hint of, you know, the song that, you know, is used. But oddly enough, the Russians, you know, they don't dance, so, and you'll see why. But that's the clip. Definitely check it out. It's really funny. It's kind of silly, you know. You guys make fun of it. It's a little bit dumb, but, you know, it's still pretty funny. And the next video is once again by Angle Summer 4. It's called Battlefield 3: What the Fuck Moment of the Day Part 4, and it's a very peculiar way of crashing a jet. And as you'll see in the video, you'll probably laugh your ass off, because it's just like, why, how, what the, I don't even, kind of thing. So definitely check out the video, it's really funny. But with that, we move on to the sixth video, which is called Battlefield 3 Exclusive Men Transporter 3000 by Mr. Awesomeness ShowShow10199, which if you guys haven't seen his videos, they are just hilarious. So check out this one, which he did, I think, yesterday or maybe today, which is just him seeing a, as you will see a lot of times, a sniper climbing up a building with his MAV drone, and he ends up doing some funny stuff to that guy. So definitely check out the video. He's always funny because his laugh is just really hilarious when he starts laughing and calls somebody camping faggot. I mean, it's just really funny. So definitely check out the video. Really funny, of course, as always. But moving on to the seventh video, which is called Meanwhile in Battlefield 3 by Crazy Chilling Dog. And this one just has, really put simply, a LAV, you know, a infantry vehicle falling, I don't know how many meters, like, it's way up there in Wake Island, just falling from the sky, I don't even know how. So check out the video, really weird and funny at the same time. So I don't even know how the hell they got a LAV so high up in the air, to be honest. Well, that they did that, so... moving on to the next one, which is called What the Fuck Battlefield 3 by Firefox 23.1094. And it's a really weird video, to be honest. It's him sniping a guy, you know, just usual, you know, bringing up the scope up to a guy's head and pulling the trigger, and bam, you know, there's blood everywhere, and nothing. He doesn't get the headshot after, like, a few tries, nothing happens, and the guy ends up killing him. So check out the video, really weird how that happened. I'm gonna accuse lag of this weird incident, so I don't know, check it out. But with that, we move on to the next one, which is called Battlefield 3 Helicopter Moment, James Bond style, by Lightex X. And it's basically him about to do some awesome stuff, you know, James Bond style, but yeah, I guess the Battlefield gods did not intend for that to happen, so some other funnier stuff happened instead of, you know, what he was expecting it to happen. So check out the video, really funny. But with that, we move on to the next one, which is called You Good, Brett, by Next Gen House. And it's just really quick video about some random guy just sliding across the battlefield, just sliding. I don't even know, he wasn't running, he wasn't walking, he wasn't crouching, he was not prone, he was just sliding across the battlefield. It's really weird, so check it out, really short. But moving on to the next one, which is called M320 versus Hilo, third person, by Troll Yalan Jr. I'm not sure. So it's basically, it wasn't him that did this, but he recorded a M320 blowing up a attack helicopter, the Havoc. So really cool how the noob tube blew up the Havoc in a particular way. So he pretty much killed the gunner and the pilot, but it didn't blow up the helicopter. So it was really strange. Check the video, really quick. But moving on to the 12th video, which is called Battlefield 3 Jeep Zug by A Fresh Monster, which has some funny stuff, because it's very similar to the Rendezvous, which you know, you probably have seen it by now, which is really awesome kill with a jet and then getting back into the jet midair. I mean, if you haven't seen that video, God, you have to see it, so I'll put it as an annotation too. So check out the Jeep Zug, which is very similar to the Rendezvous, but with a transfer vehicle instead of a jet. So just very similar. But moving on to the final video, which is called Battlefield 3, Sexiest Looking Dogfight I've Ever Seen, by Wrinkle. And it basically has just a quick, great dogfight in Cargo Island, which, you know, looks really cool, just taking off, killing a few guys, and that's pretty much it, so. But with that, guys, that's pretty much it, and as always, I never actually have time to talk about the gameplay. That was me just playing in Catching Bottle with the Scar, but as always, guys, don't forget to comment maybe about the question of the day, which is a favorite co-op weapon. Which is your favorite co-op weapon? But anyway, guys, don't forget to rate the video, subscribe to me, iBornstellar, also don't forget to subscribe to the Modern Game Studio channel, the Havocs, and with that, guys, I will see you guys on Thursday. Bye!